Good morning, children. Today we are going to revise economics fourth lesson from volume 2, Government and Taxes. As usual, we are going to revise book back objectives, 2 marks and paragraph. And this lesson is very, very important. Maybe many 2 mark questions and 2 or 3 paragraphs will be asked from this lesson. Choose the correct answer. There's 3 levels of governments in India are Union, State and Local. In India, taxes are including direct tax and indirect taxes. Which is the role of government and development policies? Defense, foreign policy, regulate the economy, all of above. Answer is all of above. The most common and important tax levied on an individual in India is income tax. Under which tax, one nation, one uniform, tax is ensured? Goods and service tax. Income tax was introduced in India for the first time in the year 1860. Wealth tax is charged on and benefits derived from property ownership. Wealth tax. What are identified as causes of black money? Shortage of goods, smuggling, high tax rate. Tax evasion is the illegal evasion of the taxes by all of the above. Payments are fees and fines, penalties and fortifiers. Fill in the blanks. Tax is levied by government for the development of the state's economy. The origin of the word tax is from the word taxation. The burden of the direct tax cannot be shifted to others. Corporate tax is levied on companies that exist as separate entities from their shareholders. The Goods and Service Tax Act came into effect on 1st July 2017. The unaccounted money that is concealed from the tax administrator is called black money. Match the following: income tax, direct tax, excise duty, indirect tax, VAT, value added tax, GST, 1st July 2017, black money, smuggling. 2 marks. Define tax. Taxes are compulsory payments to the government without expectations of direct return or benefit to the payer. Why we pay tax to the government? To raise revenue, to fund governance, or to alter prices in order to affect demand. To carry out many functions like transportation, sanitation, education, healthcare, public safety, military, scientific research, culture and the arts, and public works and insurance. Write the canons of tax system. Canons of tax system: canon of equality, canon of certainty, canon of economy and convenience, canons of productivity and elasticity. What are the types of tax? Give example. There are 2 types of tax. They are direct tax and indirect tax. Under the direct taxes, income tax, wealth tax and corporate taxes will be there. Under the indirect tax, stamp duty, entertainment, exercise and GST. Write a short note on goods and service tax. The GST was passed in Parliament on 29th March 2017. It came into effect on 1st July 2017. It aims to replace all indirect taxes levied on goods and services. What is progressive tax? When income increased, the tax rate also increases. This is known as progressive tax. What is meant by black money? The unaccounted money that is concealed from the tax administration is called black money. What is tax evasion? Tax evasion is the illegal evasion of taxes by individuals, corporations and trusts. Write some causes of the tax evasion. Some causes of tax evasion: results in black money, interfere with the government policies, it undermines the equity attribute of the tax system, it encourages the concentration of economic power, it consumes time and energy of tax administration. What is the difference between tax and payments? Tax is the compulsory payments to the government. Payment, it includes income received from the production. Now we are going to revise paragraph. Briefly explain the role of government in development policies. In this paragraph, you have to write the role of government and development policies as an introduction. In India, the three levels of governments, namely union, state and local, have been carrying out various functions for the benefit of the people. This must be written as an introduction for this paragraph, and then we have to write all the side headings like defense, foreign policy, conduct of periodic elections, law and order, public administration and provisions of public goods, and redistribution of income and poverty alleviation, and regulate the economy. All these side headings must be written. First we will see that defense. Defense is an essential security function to protect our nation from our enemies. And foreign policy, in today's world we need to maintain friendly relationship with all the other countries in the world. Conduct of periodic election. India is a democratic country. We elect our representative to parliament and the state assemblies. Law and order. Both the union and state governments enact numerous laws to protect our rights, properties and to regulate our economy and society. Public administration and provision of public goods. The government generally administers the economy and society through various departments. Redistribution of income and poverty alleviation. Governments collect various taxes to finance the various activities mentioned earlier and regulate the economy. The Union Government through the Reserve Bank of India controls money supply and controls the interest rate. These are all the points must be written for this first paragraph, like the role of government in development policies. Next paragraph, explain some direct and indirect taxes. In this direct and indirect taxes, we have to write about what is direct tax and what is indirect tax, and what are the taxes will be coming under this direct tax, like income tax, corporate tax and wealth tax. In the same way, what are all the direct taxes will be coming under the indirect taxes, like stamp duty, entertainment tax and excise duty. And even in this paragraph also we can write the definition for tax as an introduction, and then we can write direct tax. A tax imposed on an individual or organization which is paid directly is a direct tax. And in this three taxes are the income tax, corporate tax, wealth tax. Income tax. Income tax is the most common and most important tax levied on an individual in India. And corporate tax. This tax is levied on companies that exist as separate entities from their shareholders. And wealth tax. Wealth tax is charged on the benefits derived from property ownership. And then indirect taxes. In this indirect tax definition, if the burden of the tax can be shifted to others, it is an indirect tax. In this indirect tax, there are four important taxes are there: stamp duty, entertainment tax, excise duty, even we can say that GST. Stamp duty. Stamp duty is a tax that is paid on official documents like marriage registration or documents related to the property, and in some contractual agreements like that. Entertainment tax. Entertainment tax is a duty that is charged by the government on any source of entertainment provided. For example, we can say that amusement parks, exhibitions and cinema theater, movie tickets, we can say. Excise duty. An excise tax is any duty on manufactured goods levied at the moment of manufacture. And GST. GST is also one of the important tax of the indirect taxes, and the act came into effect on 1st July 2017. The motto is one nation, one market, one tax. So these are all the taxes, the types of taxes, direct taxes as well as the indirect taxes we have to write for this paragraph. And the third one, write the structure of GST. In this paragraph we have to write about what is GST, and when this act was passed in the parliament, and either it is a direct tax or indirect tax, all the information must be written for this paragraph also. So in the introduction we have to write, the goods and service tax is one of the indirect taxes. The GST was passed in parliament on 29th March 2017. The act came into effect on 1st July 2017. The motto is one nation, one market, one tax. And goods and service tax is defined as the tax levied when a consumer buys a good or service. The aim is to replace all indirect taxes levied on goods and services by the central and state government. And this structure of goods and service tax, this is only very, very important for this paragraph. And state goods and service tax, SGST, intrastate within the state, VAT, value added tax, sales tax, purchase tax, entertainment tax, luxury tax, lottery tax and state surcharge and seizures. And central goods and service tax, intrastate within the state, central excise duty, service tax, countervailing duty, additional duty of customs, surcharge, education and secondary, higher secondary seizures. And integrated goods and service tax, IGST, interstate integrated GST. There are four major GST rates, 5%, 12%, 18% and 28%. Almost all the necessities of life like vegetables and food grains are exempted from this tax. All the information must be right for this paragraph. And the next paragraph is, what is black money? Write the causes of black money. So in this we have to write what is black money. Definition for black money as a introduction. Black money is funds earned on the black market on which income and other taxes have not been paid. And the causes of black money, several sources of black money are identified as causes. First cause, we can say shortage of goods. Shortage of goods, whether natural or artificial, is the most cause of black money. Licensing proceeding. It is firmly believed that the system of controls, permits, codes and licenses are associated with mall distribution of commodities in short supply and contribution of the industrial sector. Industrial sector has been the major contributor to black money and smuggling. Smuggling is one of the major sources of black money. And tax structure. When the tax rate is high, more black money is generated. So there are five important causes of black money. One is shortage of goods, licensing proceedings, the contribution of the industrial sector, smuggling and tax structure. So all these five points must be written for this paragraph. And explain the role of taxation in economic development. In this paragraph, we have to write all the role of taxation in the economic field that we have to write in this paragraph. Taxes and development. The role of taxation in developing economics is as follows. First one is resource mobilization. Taxation enables the government to mobilize a substantial amount of revenue and reduction in inequalities of income. Taxation follows the principle of equity. The direct taxes are progressive in nature. Also, certain indirect taxes such as taxes on luxury goods is also progressive in nature. Social welfare. Taxation generates social welfare. Social welfare is generated due to higher taxes on certain undesirable products like alcoholic products, foreign exchange. Taxation encourages exports and restricts imports. Generally, developing countries and even the developed countries do not impose taxes on export items. Regional development. Taxation plays an important role in regional development. Tax incentives such as tax holidays for setting up industries in backward regions, which includes business firms to set up industries in such regions. Control of inflation. Taxation can be used as an instrument for controlling inflation. Through taxation, the government can control inflation by reducing the tax on the commodities. So these are all the five important paragraphs from this lesson. Totally, when we compare to this previous lesson and the next lesson, this taxes, government and taxes, this lesson is very, very important. Maybe many questions will be asked from this lesson. So please learn 2 marks and paragraph thoroughly very well from this lesson. Thank you, children. The next lesson we can see through next video. Thank you.